not gonna live by what I feel. Cause deep down I know that you're here with me. And I know that you can do anything. Through you, I can do anything. Yes, I can do all things. Nothing is impossible. Through you, blind eyes are open. Strongholds are broken. I am living by faith. Nothing is impossible. Through you, I can do anything. Yes, I can do all things. Cause it's you who gives me strength. Nothing is impossible. Through you, blind eyes are open. Strongholds are broken. I am living by faith. Nothing is impossible. Through you, I can do anything. Yes, I can do all things. Cause it's you who gives me strength. Nothing is impossible. Through you, blind eyes are open. Strongholds are broken. I am living by faith. Nothing is impossible. I'm not gonna live by what I see. I'm not gonna live by what I feel. Cause deep down I know that you're here with me. And I know that you can do anything. Through you I can do anything. I can do all things. Cause it's you who gives me strength. Nothing is impossible. Blind eyes are open. Strongholds are broken. I am living by faith. Nothing is impossible. Through you, I can do anything. Yes, I can do all things. Cause it's you who gives me strength. Nothing is impossible. Through you, blind eyes are open. Strongholds are broken. I am living by faith. Nothing is impossible.
Praise God, praise God. Clap your hands unto the Lord. He's worthy of every praise. Amen, amen, amen. Well, good old cold Wednesday night. Everybody's wrapped up, tied up, and tangled up in a coat somewhere. And you could be in front of a nice big old fireplace tonight, keeping warm, but you chose to come to the house of God, didn't you? Isn't God good to us? He's so good to you. Thank you for your faithfulness. Thank you for your faithfulness. Praise God. You may go back to your seat if you'd like. Amen. Thank you for the musicians. Oh, y'all sing so good. And we'll probably sing another song. Praise God here in a minute. But amen. Tonight, I think we're going to do a little bit different than our normal church service. And I want to see. I have noticed this. That when I'm thankful, I feel so much better in the Lord when I'm thankful. And even under stress, you still can be thankful. You know, I guess being that, I think I can relate to some of y'all tonight. I've I've kind of changed my mode a little bit. I'm building this house and I'm pastoring and all of this, and the pressure's there. But it's a good pressure. I find myself more faithful than I do when I'm not under the pressure. I'm tired, but I find myself getting up earlier and getting in tune with God. I'm tired because first of all, I'm almost 65, and I'm not young anymore. Let's put it this way, I'm not a youngster like I used to be. So I find myself having to adjust to a little bit different lifestyle when you get my age. But there's some things that I can praise Him about tonight. That in stressful, hard times, that's when I do my best. That's when I'm more faithful. That's when I'm more thankful. It's under the pressure. Like other people that work real good under pressure. Donald Trump, he works good under pressure. I won't go no further than that. But pressure is not always bad. Now, it can be if you fall under pressure. But the pressure is there to test you and to see what you're made out of. What kind of goods are you made out of? Do you just go to church just to hear the songs, and it makes you have mood swings, good mood swings, and you get happy, and then when you go home, you're unhappy? I want to carry something always. I want to always carry something home with me. I'm not here tonight just to play church and go home. You know, just sing a few songs. And I am so thankful that God has brought me out to put me in. And no matter what comes my way and whatever. I've on this job, I have found out that I've had to be not only velvet. My wife tells me I'm mushy sometimes. She says, "Give me the phone, I'll take care of it." I said, "Baby." Y'all know what I'm talking about? She says, "I'll take care of this situation." No, honey, don't do that. Just like when y'all go crazy, she says, "Give me the phone, I'll take care." No, she don't do that. I just kidding. She's more merciful, I think, with y'all. Praise God. Tonight, let's stand, and we're gonna give to the Lord, and then we're gonna do a few things different here. If there's anything I want to stress, be thankful. I'm going to read a scripture here in a minute to tell you why you need to be thankful. Not just because you're a churchgoer, not just because you know God. All right, let's pray. Upon the authority of your word, I have given, and it shall be given unto me, pressed down, shaken together, and running over. I am a tither. I bring my tithes today in the storehouse. Therefore, the enemy is rebuked and the curse is broken. I live under an open heaven. You pour out upon me such a blessing that there's not enough room to receive. We rejoice in jobs, better jobs, raises and bonuses, sales and commissions, benefits and settlements, estates and inheritance, interest and incomes, rebates and returns, checks in the mail, gifts and surprises, paid off bills, debts demolished, and royalties received. My whole family saved and walking with God in perfect health and abundance to walk in the divine favor and the blessings. I am blessed going in and I am blessed going out. All that I do will prosper in Jesus' name. Amen. Praise God. Give to the Lord tonight. Praise God. Amen.
Mender of the broken, you're the healer of the soul. Redeemer of all yesterdays, oh, I will bless you, Lord. Maker of the heavens, the oceans and the skies, all the earth rejoices. It's you we glorify. It's you we glorify. And mender of the broken, you're the healer of the soul. Redeemer of all yesterdays, oh, I will bless you, Lord. And maker of the heavens, the oceans and the skies, the earth rejoices, it's you we glorify, it's you we glorify. And I will bless the Lord, I will bless the Lord at all times. I will bless the Lord at all times. At all times, I will bless you, Lord. Your praise will always be forever in my mouth, forever on my lips. I will bless you, Lord. Your praise will always be forever in my mouth, forever on my lips. And I will bless the Lord, I will bless the Lord at all times, at all times.
Give the Lord a hand clap of praise all over the house. Amen, amen, amen. You may be seated if you would like. I believe that it's time that we not only are thankful just in holidays, because the scripture tells us that to be thankful in everything and also in every circumstance. Found in 1 Thessalonians 5:18. When we find ourselves overwhelmed with burdens and worries and tomorrows and bad days, good days, we still can praise Him because of who He is and also the promises that He has promised. promised to never leave us nor forsake us. You need to ask yourself a question. Are you thankful no matter what tonight? No matter what kind of circumstance you're going through, or the situations you're going through, are you thankful? Even though you may have had losses of income, losses of jobs, losses of loved ones, wayward kids, or maybe you've just lost your health, wealth. I understand that such tremendous pressure can be upon a person in these circumstances and difficulties. There is a story of a man in the Bible. He had every right to be bitter, but he wasn't. The next footsteps of his quarter, he knew might be those of the guards carrying him to the execution. His only bed was hard, cold floors, cramped prison cells. Not an hour passed when he was free from constant irritation of chains and the pain of the iron shackles cutting his wrist and legs. Separated from friends, unjustly accused, brutally treated, and ever a person had a right to complain or ever had a right to be bitter, it was this man, languishing almost forgotten in a harsh prison cell in Rome. But instead of complaints, his lips rang the words and praises of thanksgiving. The man was the Apostle Paul, a man who had learned the meaning of being truly thankful, even in the midst of great adversaries and great trouble, adversities, circumstance, situations. Earlier when he had imprisoned in Rome, Paul even wrote songs, made music in his heart to the Lord, always giving thanks to God in everything. Thanksgiving, the giving of thanks to God for all his blessings, should be one of the most distinct marks of a Christian or a believer. We must never allow a spirit of ingratitude to harden our hearts and chill our relationship with God, and not only with God only, but others around us. Listen to me real close. I need you. I need you. I need our relationship intact. I don't need your harsh words. I don't need your unmerciful attitude. I need you as a person that will help me through my tomorrows and through my todays. I need that. I need you, and you need me. You need a pastor that will have passion and that will give you mercy and love you when you didn't need to be loved or deserve to be loved. Nothing can turn us into bitterness, selfishness, dissatisfied people more quickly than an ungrateful heart. Nothing will do more to restore contentment and the joy of our salvation than a true spirit of thanksgiving. Leprosy, there was 10 lepers that walked out that came to Jesus to be healed. He said, go and see the priest. All 10 left. The good thing about it, they obeyed God. they walked away from him to go to the priest like he said. Could it be because they obeyed that God healed every one of them? Because they obeyed. I think obedience will get us there. Not being hard-headed, rebellious, wanting to go against the grind, against the axe. I'm talking about going against the grain of God. I'll never get ahead by doing that. I've seen people do that. They didn't believe fat meat was greasy, so to speak. They didn't want to believe God. They didn't believe the things of God. So they went their way. And because they went their way, they have paddled upstream all the way and have nothing but trouble and trouble and trouble and trouble all of their life. Emotional problems enter into their walk. Pain enters into their walk. They can claim to have Jesus all they want to, but because of their ingrained rebellion against the things of God, do you know that unbelief is sin? Do you know that worry is sin? How can you have unbelief and worry and be thankful? No, because it all shifts you in one direction. You are over here and you're doing your best way to travel or pedal upstream to get yourself out of the problem, and you cannot be thankful because of it. It's impossible. Oh, I love just to get in God's flow. In that flow and that anointing of God, where I can feel Him, I can feel His touch, I can smile, I can be excited about what I have without all of this entanglement. I feel sorry for you if you're entangled. You go from trouble to trouble. Circumstance to circumstance, situation to situation. You never can smile. You never can get excited because you're fixing to head right back into the problem again. You live in the problem. You swim in the problem. You're going upstream all the time when you ought to just go in the flow of the Spirit. Being thankful. There is a scripture I want to read here, and I'm going to let you know what happens to people eventually. You know, I heard a man say not too long ago, and I'm going to give y'all a few minutes to talk here in a minute. I heard not too long ago a man say this. He says, you know, it looks good for a while, those that walk out. But time is not yet. Watch the fruit that they bear that follow behind them, those that waver. They don't obey God. And they don't have a heart for the things of God. I fear God tonight. I fear not to be thankful. I fear not to trust Him. I fear that. And that's why I want to trust God in all things. The Bible says in Romans, the first chapter, verse number 21, because that when they knew God, because that when they knew God, they glorified Him not as God. That could be people who have the Holy Ghost. God give you the Holy Ghost, the power of God, the power of God to overcome every obstacle that's in your way. But yet, you didn't glorify Him. You wasn't thankful while you had Him. You didn't get excited about what God's doing in your life at the time you got him. I believe that a person that has this Holy Ghost experience ought to be excited about what they've got. Because you've got the anointing wrapped up inside of you if you will let it out. You got the same Holy Ghost I got. You got the same anointing power that I got inside. It's how you present what you've got. Come on, am I communicating now? It's not what goes in, it's what goes out. I'm not moved by people that speak in tongues, just speaking, rattling. I'm not moved by gifts. I'm moved by character. That's what I'm moved at. I'm looking for people that have the character of God. I'm looking for people that have the fruit of the Spirit. I told God today, I said, God, if you don't gift me one bit, I like gifts. Don't get me wrong. And I do care. I want gifts. I said, but if you don't give me gifts, give me fruit. I'd rather have fruit in my life than I would gifts. I've seen a lot of people have fruit. And they're behind the scene. You don't hear of them. You don't even hear their name mentioned, and they don't care to have it mentioned. But the fruit is radiant from them. And then you have these other ones that can talk in tongues and interpretate all this stuff, and they go out and some of them live like the devil. But that they knew God, then they didn't glorify him. They glorified him not as God. Neither were they thankful. Now, look at the deterioration right now in this scripture. They knew God, but they didn't glorify him as God. Neither they were thankful, but then became vain in their imaginations. Y'all listen to me. If you don't glorify God and classify him and be thankful for what God is in your life, then you're going to become in vain in your imaginations. The devil is going to play havoc on your mind, because that is the production or what is produced by not being thankful. What happens is you become vain in your imaginations and the devil plays havoc on you. Neither were they thankful. They became vain in their imaginations, and their foolish heart was darkened. You get no revelation. You get no understanding of what God is trying to do in your walk with God. You're numb when it comes to spiritual realm, because you become vain in your imaginations. Do y'all know what vain imaginations is? Thinking about things that are not there. Things that you think upon that you cannot, it's not even alive. My past, when I think of my past, guess what? It's dead. There's nothing to think about anymore. It cannot do anything of my future because it's dead. Old things passed away. Behold, all things in front of me become brand new. Professing themselves to be wise, they become fools and change the glory of uncorruptible God into an image made like a corruptible man. I want to go to verse number 24. Wherefore God then gave them up. Don't go to the extent where you are so drenched and cannot believe God that you lose everything and then God just has to turn you over. Do y'all see the stair step of unthankfulness? vain imaginations, foolish heart darkened. Because they were not thankful. I'm going to stop right there. There are people here tonight that are thankful. And I'm opening this thing up. I need a mic. I need somebody to help me up here with a mic and grab that mic and let people talk. We're in a season where it's Thanksgiving. We ought to be thankful. Families ought to love one another, care about one another. Show mercy to your family. Who's going to be first? She's going to be first as she's got the mic, right? A season of Thanksgiving. Thanksgiving. Go ahead.
I'm thankful for so much in my life. Today's my birthday, so I'm thankful for another year, 33. No, I'm really thankful. Sometimes, you know, during the holiday seasons, you kind of reflect on your past. And when you were talking, I can't help but always think of my mom and dad, and you were talking about how if you leave a church and you can take your hard feelings with you. And I remember when my brother passed away, that was one of the things that they said was, we're not going to leave the church. It doesn't matter what happens. We're not leaving the church, because my mom always said, you can't take that with you. Unforgiveness goes wherever you go. And so tonight, I'm just thankful for my parents raising me in the truth, staying faithful. That's one thing they taught me. You know, it doesn't matter. I know, like, if you're sick in your body and you got disease, I'm like something that's catching, don't come to church. But, you know, if I'm just in pain and maybe I'm just hurting in my back or something, I know that I need to go to the house of God unless I just can't, because my parents taught me faithfulness. And I'm just thankful for my church. I'm thankful for my family. I'm thankful for you guys. And I'm blessed, and I'm thankful for that.
One of the main things is you never stop growing as long as you're willing to grow. And with the growing, it's like a whole nother set of blessings comes with growing as long as you're faithful to God. For example, just learning to be better about giving finances, then, you know, blessings come with that. Learning to try new ministries, blessings come with that. It's just you never stop learning, and then it just gets better and better, and it's like it's not like you ever hit a ceiling or anything. You just keep going, and it's like a whole other set of stuff comes along with it that just benefits your life and makes your life that much better.
Somebody else.
I can go on and on about thankfulness. But tonight, I'm thankful for the church. Amen. I'm thankful for every single one of you guys. I'm thankful for my beautiful family. Thankful for God's provision, and that He's always faithful. He always takes care of us. And we see His hand working every day, Suzanne and I. And so we're very thankful for that. I'm thankful for what He's doing in my extended family. I see God moving. He's putting some things together, and I'm excited about that. So,
I'm thankful for my beautiful family, my Katie Cakes, healthy children. Is a blessing. I went for a review. You know, we get a yearly review at work, and you know, like 8 or 9 years ago, my boss, she says, "Well, I don't know why you got the highest raise in the store." And now she says, Well, you got the highest raise in the store. Don't tell anybody. So we've come a long way, me and her. So, you know, then 9 years later, you know, it takes a little time sometimes. So I'm blessed for a very good job and a very good boss that she really looks out for me. She keeps me out of trouble. I'm a lot to handle at work. So I thank God for my wife. She's a blessing to me. She's a strong woman that does a lot and holds the household together while I'm at work. So, I mean, that's a lot too. So just I'm very blessed with the church family I have now. And, you know, there's a lot of people here that just, you guys mean a lot to me. And I'm very blessed and thankful to have you guys. And that's pretty much it.
Your wife passed you up. That's what she's wanting, you know.
She walked fast.
Yeah. The mic was in her mouth, and she didn't even eat on it.
You know, I'm extremely thankful for God's grace and His mercy. And I can't count on both my hands how many times I should not be here. I should not be alive. Through the accidents, the broken nose, the head injuries, broken jaw, drownings, you know, I mean, just so many things have come about. And for some reason, God just, you know, has kept me around. And the times that I have gone astray or backslid, and my soul was in the lost and found, and Jesus came by to claim it. And I'm very thankful for that. You know, when I turned 13, my parents gave me permission to smoke and a carton of cigarettes. Today, on the way home, I made up my mind that I'm going to quit smoking. I've had one whole cigarette today since then, and I just really don't desire one. And I've been praying that God would just kind of give me a hatred for it, but I don't know if that's right. I know that as time goes by, I'll just think of it less and less. And so I'm not really all that stressed to, you know, to be concerned about it. I know that God will, and being a child of God, I have the ability not to do that, you know. And being baptized, I should have quit when I was baptized. But now is not much of a difference, you know. I still have God's help in doing that. And on a side note, my sister works at the Willow Springs Recovery, and they're looking to hire people, techs, maintenance. You know, if anybody's looking for a job, here's an opportunity to be thankful. You know, women, guys, day shift, night shift. Anyway, that's it. Thank you.
Awesome.
Well, we went to the post office this morning. I was getting a book in the mail, and so I had Tyler go in and pick it up. And he came out, and he had a box with him. And it was from the post, and there was no addressed label on it. My name wasn't on it. Our address, our P.O. box wasn't on it. Like, is on a ticket, there was no return label. It just had, it was a plain brown box, and it said 536. It had our number on it. And I said, that's weird. And in my mind, I really honestly thought it bomb, you know, and I thought, and he's like, let's open it, and you know, it's opening, and you're like, but it ended up being, and it's so bizarre, it's awesome, and it's crazy at the same time, but it was these little egg cookers, and I have no idea how or why, And then the thought came to my mind, we're getting a gift in the mail, you know, gifts and surprises. And so anyways, it was just really, it was cool and it was funny and silly and, you know, crazy all the same time. So anyways, but it's still blessings and it's fun.
I want to thank God for everything that He's done for me. I didn't know once my wife passed that I would be able to keep the house because I didn't know if my finances would allow me to, but I thank God for helping me with the finances and helping me keep my house and just blessing me. And I thank God for the 44 years that He allowed me and my wife to be together. And the joy and the love that I feel here at this church. And I just want to give back as God's given to me. And I love God with all my heart. And I just want to get on with the rest of my life, whatever He has in store for me. And I want it to be in His will, and I want to do God's work. I want Him to use me as, and whichever way He wishes. And I just love God, and I love everybody here. They're my big family, and just thank God for helping me along. And helping me through the temptations and the trials that He's, you know, helped me through. And I thank God, and I love everybody here, and love God.
Okay, I do have a testimony. So I actually was blessed to move on from the trailer. it was my very first home, you know, so it was a little hard just because, you know, I fixed it up how I wanted it and all this, but God opened a door that I could live downstairs from Brother Robert and, you know, in and out as I please, and, you know, I have a little kitchenette and a room and, kid, you know, all the stuff that I need and way bigger place than a trailer, yes, like in a little apartment down there. I know I'm not a cooker, but I do. If, you know, if God puts it on my heart to cook, then, you know, I have it there. But
let Mama give you some lessons.
I know. Ramen noodles, right? So, but, you know, on the other side, too, you know, with having another home, you know, with all the good things about that, you know, I was actually, you know, I'm blessed to actually be paying a little bit more, too, you know, because of the job that I was blessed with, you know, a couple months ago, you know. And if I didn't have that, I wouldn't been able to have, you know, the home that I do now. So I'm so blessed. Anybody else?
Well, I have lots and lots and lots to be thankful for. For me, every morning that I awaken, it's a miracle for me. When I was a child, I never dreamed I'd live to see 73 years old, so I feel like I am blessed abundantly. And another thing I was sitting there thinking about is, you know, I am glad. I am so thankful that I'm not the person that I was before Jesus found me. I am so thankful that I'm not that person anymore. And I just thank God for he has, especially these last 17 years, in January the 10th, my husband will be gone 17 years. And I'm so thankful that God brought me to this church. I've heard Brother Chandler say many times, if we will allow this church, it will love us back to health and just love us. And that's what that church, this church, and Brother and Sister Chandler have done for me. And I'm so thankful to be a part of this church. And I love God tonight, and I appreciate Him.
I'm not shy, but I don't know why. I wasn't going to say this or say anything. I was like, no, I'm not going to say nothing, but I felt like I needed to. In about 2 weeks, my baby girl's going to be 3. And I'm so blessed because I remember when she was born, I didn't know if she was going to actually live or we were going to get to this point. I remember after her third heart surgery, they told me that they prepared me that this could possibly be her final day. And I can't believe 4 heart surgeries later, we're still here. And I'm so grateful because she is amazing. And I know that it's been hard for her with all that we have to do to keep her with us. And I know, like, when you're growing up and your parents give you a spanking, and they're like, I'm doing this because I love you. And I actually have to tell Abby, I'm like, I'm giving you a shot today, and I know you hate it, but I'm doing it because I love you, and I mean it. And I give her a hug and tell her I'm done. I'm just blessed because I know that that God is keeping her with us, and she is definitely my blessing. So is Sebastian, but I'm so grateful for her. And I'm sorry. I took her to her cardiologist about 2 months ago, and they did her echo screening of her heart. And they told me, well, I'm really shocked to tell you this, but with Abby having a mechanical valve in her heart, she should be at a level 4 is the best for a person with a mechanical valve, but she is at a 3, and that's completely rare, really rare. So I'm so blessed and grateful that I'm like, wow. So we could be not having a heart surgery for another 4 years, 5 years instead of 2. So I'm just blessed, and I'm grateful for her.
I have so much to be thankful for. One thing that came to my mind, in addition to, you know, my family, my husband, my kids, having a healthy baby, a healthy delivery, because when he was born, he came out, he was black. And, you know, even though you're kind of out of it, you're instantly thinking, oh my gosh, what just happened? Is my baby okay? But he was fine. But I'm thankful for answered prayers. I got to thinking I'm the product of an answered prayer. The church, I didn't know it was going on a 3-day fast. And we decided to come to church on the day they ended their 3-day fast. My husband's the product of an answered prayer. My mother and my brother, living for God's a product of an answered prayer. There's things that I'm still anxious to see be answered or see the fruition of things that have been prophesied over me. But I know that I can lean upon the things that have already been answered, the things I've already seen come to pass, and as I await those promises. So I'm thankful.
Well, today I was thinking about some things. And how that, you know, when I was younger, I didn't think things would come together in my life. And I can remember as a kid thinking You know, I didn't have much. Growing up, I had a bedroom that had wallpaper that was falling off the walls. And I didn't have curtains on my window. And I remember as a kid sitting in my bedroom thinking, God, someday I want a pretty bedroom. I know this sounds so stupid, but it's really something I'm thankful for. And I remember sitting in my bedroom thinking, I hope one day I have a pretty bedspread. This is real. And today I was thinking how many things God has, and I don't have to have material. I'm not, I don't have to have material. If you know me, you know I buy Goodwill and resell. But I was thinking today, I thought, God, you have over, pressed down, shaken together, running over, blessed my life. And not just with things, not just with things. I went by the house that I grew up in a few months ago. And we drove by that house. It is, as a kid, you think, oh, it's a big house. It had three bedrooms. And it is a little white shack in Pasadena that looks like, I mean, the windows are boarded up. It literally looks like it's an abandoned shack in the middle of town. And we drove by there here a while back, and I sat there, I just cried in the parking lot. I said, babe, I thought I had so much, because when you don't have much, you think it's much. And I was thinking today how far God has brought me from those days and how thankful I am. When my husband talks about being thankful, I really feel thankful. I sat in the car today and I told God, I said, you have blown my mind. You have blown my mind. And I'm thankful, not just thankful, I'm grateful, not just for the things I have. But I have a daughter in Dallas that is living for God and pastoring a church and ministering, and she's amazing. Mindy's amazing. I have a son-in-law that is living for God. And, you know, I showed some of you a picture, and I don't know if you saw it on Facebook, of my little 3-year-old grandson praying at the altar, 3 years old. If you haven't seen it, I really wanted to put it on the overhead, because I really want to teach a lesson on this is why.
This is why.
This is why.
It's good.
And I really want to teach something some Wednesday night on this. This is why I keep going. This is why I've pushed. This is why you don't offend me enough. You may make me mad for the moment. I've had people make me fight mad for a moment, but ain't nobody going to steal what God's done in my life. Nobody. And that little picture of my 3-year-old grandbaby praying at the altar, that's plastered in my mind. And that's why I've never slowed up. I've never backed up. I've never given in. I've never run. I've never picked up things God delivered me from, because you know what? And now I'm getting the fruit of that. And when I got that picture of my baby at the altar, and it was amazing. Brother Matthews that was here a few months ago, saw Chandler coming towards the altar. He went down there and sat down on the altar. And Chandler just started crying. He's 3 years old. He's not even three. He'll be four, that's right, in March. So he's three. But he told Brother Mathis, he said, I'm sorry, Jesus. That's what he told him. He said, I'm sorry, Jesus. It blew my mind. And then he just started crying. And he grabbed Brother Mathis and just held on to him, because he felt God. So when we talk about being thankful, boy, I could just go on and on and on. I'm thankful. I am so grateful to what God's done. You know, I've got family that are living for God. The devil could have killed us, destroyed us. You know, I mean, when you know you're under pressure and you don't think right, and you say things and you do this and you do that, And you have to back up and repent. And you have to back up and say, you know what? I did that wrong. And you have to say, I'm sorry. Someone here a while back said, how have you made it? We'll be married 46 years. I said, forgiveness. That is the number, I'm telling you, you hear me, that is the number one key to marriage, is forgiveness. Forgiving each other, because you offend your spouse, whether you believe it or not, you do. And you have to forgive. Forgiveness is the number one key to marriage. And I'm thankful. I'm thankful for a godly husband. I'm thankful for that. I sometimes I wake up in the morning at 4. He wakes up at 4 something. I try to sleep till 5. I'm trying. But I wake up and I hear him in there crying or praying. Wow. I'm thankful. You want me to keep going? You shouldn't have gave me the mic. That's all I'm saying. Okay, who else is thankful in here? You're awful, awesome too. David, did you have your hand up? You ain't thankful? Sister, I'm glad to see you tonight. She's back.
Absolutely. Good to see her tonight. Let's give her a hand.
I absolutely love services like this, to give God the glory for everything that he's done in our life. We think about things that come into our life, and sometimes in our flesh, we think, oh, this is bad. But everything that happens to us filters through his hands, and there's a reason that it's happening. There's a blessing behind everything. There are times that, for example, okay, I broke my toe. Because of that, they ran an EKG because it caused me to have chest pains. All this stuff showed up on the EKG. So that made us have to go to the cardiologist. When we got to the cardiologist 10 days later, everything was gone. It wasn't there anymore. That was a witness. We can feel sorry for ourselves when we come across things bad, but we have to realize God puts us in situations to reach souls that are crying out. We don't know what they're going through. And we have to get the focus off us and onto them. And I am so thankful for a praying church. We came into church in 2000. That church, I heard somebody say that they had a 3-day fast. That church had been fasting. My sister lived in Texas, we're in Florida. She called them. They put our family's name, didn't even know us. They put our family's name on their prayer list and prayed for 3 weeks. They had a long list of people. We came in on a revival. So even though you don't know them, even though you've never seen them, don't give up. Keep praying. God has put us here to reach souls. Whatever situation we're in, we're to be thankful for that. I look at all the things God has protected us from. You know, sometimes we pray for things amiss and we don't. And I'm thankful I didn't get some of the things we prayed for. I'm thankful for all the things we've been through because it grows us and molds us and makes us strong for the kingdom. My daughter, and I always, every year when we have our thankful service, she says, Mom, you took my testimony. She was diagnosed with autism, and God healed her instantly at the altar. He took the seizures away. He took the integrated sensory disorder away. He took the autism away from her. And he gave my daughter back to me. I am so thankful for that every day. He gave her a heart for souls. He gave her a heart for missions. So when you get discouraged with things that are going on around, look at your children. Gather your strength. Put your armor on and you pick up that sword and you fight because you got children coming up behind you that they're going to make a strong army for God to bring souls in.
I'm going to say one more thing. My mom, she has been sober, I think this month, 11 months. So that's a blessing.
I just want to thank God for his blessings in my life. I'm just thankful because God's brought me a long way this year. He brought me back home where I belong. He's healed some things in my life. I'm not where I want to be, but I'm striving to go forward into God and trust God. That's something I do have a trouble with, just for the fact of life. I think I'm not trusting people. It rubs off sometimes of me trusting God solely, but I've been praying for my kids. And I told God, I said, I want to see my children come back in 2019 because I know God's getting ready to come back and I don't want my kids lost. So I'm just trusting that God's going to answer that prayer this year, that they're all going to come back.
I have a blessing. I'm thankful to God that I got baptized and so did Liberty and so did Elizabeth and a few of my friends. Isabel, I'm glad that she got baptized. And all of the other kids who did. I am blessed for my family and my friends at school.
Who else is thankful? Anybody else?
My grandma had a visit, and my grandma was
busy. She's thankful for her grandma.
She's thankful for her grandma.
It was okay. So she was saying I should say something about the service Sunday. When we went to Junction, we went to Junction Sunday, if y'all didn't know. And so we went there, and you know, we went there just to be with people. She wanted to be with some of her family. Was it four generations of, you know, people in her family that has prayed through so far in her family, and that was there. So we went there and we supported, you know, Sister Leanne and Brother Shad. And, you know, this is actually something I'm going to say just a few things, but anyway, let me say something about the service. So the service was really good. It was Brother Bernard, and he, honestly, okay, I'm going to be honest, okay, because, so, you know, sometimes he can talk over your head, you know, because he's very intelligent, he's very smart, and sometimes you can't understand him. Me, I can't, okay, I might just be me, But so I was kind of, you know, I was like, oh, this is great. But I was kind of scared. I was not going to understand everything. But, you know, he talked in such a very simple way. And I was just like, whoa. You know, God knew that I needed something. And everybody else did too. You know, and so it was very simple. It was very good. Wonderful service. You should watch it on Facebook. So another thing. Me and Sarah, we helped Sister Leanne with the Sunday school and stuff, and they had some snacks going on, and we went and helped her out. Well, they did hot dogs, and when we went in the kitchen where they have their kitchen, it was smoking. Like, there was such a thick haze of smoke in there. If we didn't go in there when we did, it probably would have had a fire. And so we went in, and like the weenies, you know, there was no water in the pot at all. It was totally burnt at the bottom, you know. And so, I mean, it was God that we actually went in there. Yeah, the salt shaker was actually on the oven, and it was actually melted, like it melted from the heat. And so anyways, but when we went in there, it was so smoky. Thank God we went in when we did, because we saved their building. Okay, I think that's it. Yes. Yes. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yes, yes. So everybody got food.
So I want to testify again. I kind of was caught off a little off guard while ago, but I really want to also say that I'm very thankful for my husband. He works very hard for our family, and I just see God bringing him such a long way. When Sister Chandler was talking about that earlier, I didn't mention that, but I do. I think often, I remember when we came here where we were, and, you know, Brendan teases all the time we didn't know if we were going to make it, but it really wasn't a joke. And I just see how God is, he has his hand on us, and I just see him working. And I'm also thankful that we found out that we can get a USDA loan. So that is a blessing. God's working in our finances, and I'm just really thankful. Another thing I told Brandon today, and this may sound silly, but I'm thankful for it. When I first married Brandon, his dad really wasn't on my side, and he didn't care for me too much. He didn't want us to get married. But today, and I know it's just Facebook, but I actually felt when he told me that he was really glad that I was his daughter-in-law and I'm doing an awesome job with my children. I just felt like something was mending, and I'm very thankful for that, because through the years it hasn't been easy, and I'm just very thankful.
Awesome. Let's all stand. We have no reason not to be thankful. No reason. Praise God. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, I come before the throne of grace for the people of God. When I pray in the mornings and when I pray for them, I feel an unction in my spirit to tell the people to press forward. Father, when they press forward, they're going to find new things. God, you're going to open their understandings to new things. New things in God. Father, there's nothing new under the sun. It just must be revealed. God, I'm asking you to reveal yourself to this church. And Lord, bring us into a fruitful year. Help us, Lord, to win souls. Souls, souls, souls. God must be the goal for 2019 as it approaches us. And Lord, I'm thankful for this church body. I'm thankful for every person that you've placed under my ministry. And God, I ask you, Lord, to protect them as they walk out this church house tonight. Lord, as they go home and go on their jobs tomorrow, I pray the hand of God be resting upon them. And Lord, in the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen. Shake somebody's hand. Be friendly. Love God.